rather more circumspect, but his team built on solid defence and the predatory goal instincts of Tim Cahill and Harry Kewell will quietly fancy their chances of returning to this stadium in 4 days' time as well. So, Andy Harper, it's a big night for both nations.
Well, there's no doubt they both be very proud of the fact that they're at semi-final stage. They've turned over new soil, both teams, in achieving just that. Uzbekistan have been trying longer than Australia, of course. Nevertheless, it's been a successful campaign for both teams, and for one of them, of course, by definition, is going to find this even more joyous and more successful as they qualify for the final. But I think it's going to be a fascinating game. You know, Australia and Uzbekistan had to face up to each other in stage four of World Cup qualifying for 2010. South Africa, Australia had the edge on Uzbekistan, but you don't get the feeling they're going to have it quite their own way here tonight.
Well, we've seen real drama in the first semi-final between Japan and South Korea. It went all the way to penalties, with Japan coming out successful. What awaits us tonight, and what awaits Japan in the final back here at Khalifa Stadium? It's Uzbekistan against Australia in the second semi-final of this 15th Asian Cup. And here come the teams. Well, today may be Australia Day, but will it be Australia's Day? The women are Asian champions, the juniors reach the under-19 final. Could the Socceroos complete the set, or will Uzbekistan, said to be so confident they didn't even practice penalties, spoil the party? Let's have a look at the two teams, starting with Uzbekistan, who've rung the changes again. Four in all, Shatskik and Karpenko. The two veterans return, as does defender Anzor Ismailov. And Ignati Nesterov's hand injury has not recovered quickly enough, so Temur Jurayev keeps goal. Two-goal hero against Jordan, Ulugbek Bakayev retains his place. Tursunov and Gainrik and Mulajanov drop down to the bench. Our referee today, Ali Al-Badwawi, he's used to keeping law and order. He's the lieutenant colonel in the Dubai police force. His two assistants are also from the UAE, Saleh Al-Marzouki and Yasser Maratz. The two captains, Serdar Japarov of Uzbekistan, Lucas Neal of Australia.
He will choose the AFC and referee. Okay. Referee here, which side you need, and you will start with the ball. Good luck, brother. Good luck, one.
There we go. You got it loud and clear. Uzbekistan will kick off. Australia had the choice events. Holger Osik has gone with an unchanged side, despite having Brett Emerton available again after suspension. So he's decided to stick with Brett Holman on the right flank, and that means Matt Mackay retains his spot on the left. It's a big day for goalkeeper Mark Schwarzer. Tonight he equals Alex Tobin's all-time appearance record as he wins his 87th cap. Vadim Abramov, the Uzbekistan coach, the word Uzbek translates in English to real leader. And Abramov has been just that, cool, calm and confident. He's aiming for a slice of history this evening. And Holger Osik in jovial mood at yesterday's press conference. Could he now become the first Australian coach since Terry Venables to lead the Socceroos to a final? So, second time lucky, we're away. Two of the youngest members of the Asian Football Confederation set to fight it out for a place in the Asian Cup final. Uzbekistan joined 17 years ago, Australia just five. Which of the juniors is ready to make the leap to seniority, Andy Harper?
Well, I should think, Simon, they're both putting their hand up for that one, which is why it's going to be a fascinating game. Uzbekistan, I think, have developed nicely through the tournament, although they haven't quite been tested. Not to the extent that Australia and certainly South Korea and Japan had been tested to semi-final stage. So that can certainly help them. They can be fresh and ready to explode here today. Or they might find the upgrade in pressure and intensity and quality of opposition something they hadn't quite planned for. Either way, it's going to be great to watch. They're well coached, very well coached. He's a smart operator, this Vadim Abramov. And of course, in charge of the Socceroos, Holger Osik, is no mug either. He's done a great job so far.
Serdar Japarov squaring it up. Haidarov trying to prod it through for the return ball. Bright start by Uzbekistan. Now here's the dangerous Kasimov. Seen some of his work at this Asian Cup. He'll be a real threat and a real test for Luke Wiltshire down that right-hand defensive side for Australia. Perfect night in Doha. Clear skies, mild temperatures, surface 100% perfect. Now David Carney, too slow, little bit hesitant. Uzbekistan onto it immediately. There's Kapadze trying to dig it out, but Australia get it up to Harry Kewell on halfway. And now Jedinak, chance for a counter for Australia. Holman slips it through. Tim Cahill forced wide. And really had no other option but to take it early.
Well, a breather as much as anything for Australia, Simon. 2 minutes in, they've very flat-footed defensively. One can understand the sluggishness. They had to slug out their quarter-final against Iraq to extra time, of course. And that doesn't come without a price paid. Just the 2 days to recover. Uzbekistan have had the extra day plus no extra time. And no surprise they've started the fresher. Australia will need to get the cobwebs out quick, smart, or they're going to be chasing this game before they know it.
Australia have pickpocketed the ball here. Brett Holman feeding Tim Cahill. Three to aim for. Drops here for Holman! Oh, what a save by Temel Jurev at his near post. But what a chance for Australia to take the lead in just the third minute.
Well, brilliant chance for Australia. And already we're seeing that as good as Uzbekistan and clever as they are going forward, that's a terrific piece of work by Temel Jurev at his near post. But defensively, they're suspect. They haven't been tested in this tournament. That's the point. Qatar game one were disappointing. Kuwait game three barely stretched them.
Mackay's corner. And the whistle's gone for some pushing inside the penalty area.
It was Kuwait game two, and China fighting for their lives forced the draw. But this is good harassment in midfield. Brett Holman there or thereabouts, he's been outstanding in that facet of Australia's play. He got good contact. I'm not sure if it was quite the contact he wanted, but it was good enough to force some nervous moments in Uzbekistan's goal. Jureyev, excellent when his team needed him.
You mentioned the Uzbekistan defence, Andy. They've played with a back three in the last game against Jordan. Looks very much as though they've gone back to a four-man back line this evening.
And this is part of the Vadim Abramov approach. He changes things around. Bakayev, the two-goal hero from the quarter.
Here's Matt Mackay trying to get Australia going again. Harry Kuehl! Harry Kuehl scores! What a finish! And Australia are in front in the fifth minute. And Harry Kuehl is on fire at this Asian Cup. Finished, not on your life. His third goal of the tournament. The perfect start for the green and gold.
Well, Harry Kuehl's left foot let him down and Australia down in the quarterfinal against Iraq. It was his head that saved the day for the Socceroos just days ago now. But it is that trusty left foot. And we're going to marvel at the finish. But what about the lead-up play from the skipper of the Brisbane Roar, Matt Mackay? And what a combination that's developing between these two lefties. Mackay to Kuehl to the back of the net. And the Socceroos are away.
Well, it's the sort of unerring finish we've been watching for the best part of two decades. And you said it, Andy, the Uzbekistan defence is a little fragile. And Australia have made them pay. Cash, early doors in this semi-final. What a start for the Socceroos. A long way to go, though, in this second semi-final. The winners to play Japan, remember. They were victorious over South Korea on penalties earlier on today. Was that a foul by Valeri? The Uzbek team certainly thought so.
Well, Australia heavily criticised from their own. In fact, Holger Osik leading the chorus of discontent about the quality of the finishing. And it's taken them only their third sight on goal here tonight. Tim Cahill had the first shot on the counter. Brett Holman forcing that excellent save. Third time lucky for the Socceroos, although there was no measure of luck about it. A superb piece of football by two very talented players, Matt Mackay, Harry Kuehl. And Matt Mackay got a save, vindicating his selection in the starting 11 with Brett Emerton available.
Here's Serdar Japarov. If there is a good thing for Uzbekistan, it's that the goal has come very, very early.
Well, Karpenko on the ball now, very experienced campaigner, was rested for the quarter. This is part of the Abramov approach. Shatskik and Karpenko were rested. He didn't bring Bakayev into the starting 11 until the quarter final. He scored those two goals in a couple of minutes.
That's casual by Ismailov. And Australia could be away again here, but I think that's going to be too far for Mackay.
And even on the counter-attack, you saw Matt Mackay spring into the space, the vacant space of right fullback where Viktor Karpenko should be. He's not going to be able to foot it with Mackay if it turns into a open foot race repeatedly.
What a tournament Matt Mackay has had. This is the talented Akhmadov Now Japarov out to Kasanov. Cutting inside. Shevchuk lets it roll. Now Kapadze. Good build-up play by Uzbekistan, but Makai is there again. Holman forced backwards. Maybe the hint of a foul there too. Now Odil Akhmedov looking for Bakayev in the channel.
Right, he's one to watch coming out of midfield for Australia, Odil Akhmedov. And it is certainly the case that Tim Cale and Harry Kuehl need to make sure that any other defender rather than he carries the ball into midfield. Terrific work, Matt Mackay. The reverse angle and the pitches, some of the camera work and pitches here at Asia Cup 2011 have been mouthwatering.
So was that finish.
Beautiful.
Absolutely terrific. He got the winner against Iraq in the quarters. And he's got Australia off to a flyer in the semis. And Australia, remember, have conceded just one goal at this tournament. The defence has been pretty strong. That's a heavy touch from Carney. Now Haidarov. To Viktor Karpenko. Japarov into the channel. And Shatskik just getting the wrong side of Valeri for a fraction. And there's Makai again. Maybe that's why Holger Osik has decided to stick with Makai, because if he brought Brett Emerton in, as much as Emerton gives you a lot going forward, Brett Holman doesn't quite give you the same insurance policy down the left.
No, indeed. It's a more balanced team this way because of that left-hand side situation. You're quite right. And Brett Holman's form has been such that Holger Osik, quite understandably, hasn't wanted to sacrifice him. And it's an enormous advantage for Australia and comfort to have someone like Emerton on the bench. But indeed, on the Uzbek bench, they've got plenty of firepower as well, if they need it. We mentioned Tursunov, the right flanker, who can certainly motor. Alexander Geinrich, perhaps injured coming into the game, but he certainly knows how to attack an opponent's goal as well. So there's plenty of room for both teams to work in the substitutes, if needs be. Serva Jeparov, Odil Akhmedov are the two really in possession for Uzbekistan that the Socceroos are going to have to watch.
I just wanted to make the point here, Andy. At last, a referee has spotted a foul throw. We must have had 100 of them at these tournament.
You've almost been throwing up your breakfast every morning at the state of the throw-in in the Asian Cup. Finally, you've got your way.
Kuehl holds it up well. Holman. Just beyond Jedinak, but Australia forage for it again. This is Valeri. Forced wide. Where Makai is positioned. Carney looking for Cahill. Uzbekistan, they're not sure defensively at all, are they?
No, they're not. But in this phase of the game, Australia's going to have to react very quickly. Coming out from the back, they're very tidy.
Shots kick.
Japarov, the number eight, Australian fans will know him a lot. He's very mobile, he takes up all sorts of positions. Defenders, midfielders are going to have to watch him.
Now, Shatskik just found some room. Here is Japarov. He is all left foot, but a bit like Maradona. It's not a bad left peg. Akhmedov, who can shoot from range, we know that. Can he find the space? Haidarov, back to Japarov, and now Viktor Karpenko. Just hit Shatskik, I think, on the chest. Maxim Shatskik, veteran these days at 32, but what a striker he's been down the years, particularly for Dynamo Kiev, as Japarov gets the cross in. And Ognjanovski away from harm's way. Great start for Holger Osik. Won the CONCACAF Gold Cup, the North and Central American regional title 11 years ago. Could be a rare double if Australia were to lift the trophy here. That's still some way off, of course. Holman forcing Wilkshire to check. Valeri. And he was holding Bakayev back.
Yeah, just too powerful there, Bakayev. Probably a bit of six of one, half a dozen of the other, really, but the referee saw it how he saw it. No drama. Kasanov on the left-hand side, of course, you've mentioned his name a couple of times, Simon. Again, not great defensively, but very, very dangerous going forward. A beautiful cross on him.
He absolutely tore Qatar to ribbons at this stadium on match day one, didn't he? This is Brett Holman, operating in a very tight space. Kuhl has peeled wide left. Mackay offering support. Clear foul by Shatskik. Two old and talented hands going toe-to-toe.
It's a pretty crude challenge from Maxim Shatskik. He was blown if he was chasing any further. His ageing legs. And again, Karpenko, Shatskik on the right-hand side for Uzbekistan. Going to find Matthew Mackay very, very difficult to cope with physically.
Mackay it will be to deliver the free kick. Australia have added height for the set piece in the shape of Ognjanovski, Neil, Jedinak. Cahill, of course, can leap, we know that. So plenty of firepower there. But it's knotted clear by Akhmadov, only as far as Carney. Mackay will set it up again. Up climbs Jedinak. And Carney was sniffing for any fumble from the goalkeeper. Uzbekistan away through Odil Akhmadov. Just on that, Harry Kuhl, Andy, 14 years ago, he scored against Uruguay in a Confederations Cup semi-final to put Australia into their first ever final. Could history be about to repeat itself, maybe?
Sometimes that has a habit of doing just that, doesn't it? Really the longest serving member. I know he hasn't got as many caps as Mark Schwarzer, but he is the sole survivor from the MCG disaster of 1997 and the Confeds Cup games around then.
And isn't it great to see him looking so fit and in form? We're used over the past few years to talking about a brittle and a broken Harry Kuehl.
Well, he's in as good a shape as he's been. The word out of Socceroo HQ is that mentally, psychologically, he's as fresh as he's ever been too.
Now, chance here for Uzbekistan. Bakayev, that's a bit of a heavy challenge from Luke Wiltshire in the opinion of Ali Al-Badwawi. Wiltshire says he got the ball.
Well, this is a very handily placed free kick for Uzbekistan. My initial reaction was that he got the ball. I think in most parts of the field that'd be play on.
Has he gone over the top of the ball?
He has gone over. Oh, credit to the referee. The referee saw it, acted swiftly. Australia can't have any real complaints.
So Luke Wiltshire's going to be on a knife edge. We've only played 15 minutes. Mark Schwarzer, the record equaling Mark Schwarzer, may be about to be called into action for the first time. Shatskik and Japarov discussing who's going to take this free kick. Would probably suit the right-footed Shatskik. Unless Japarov fancies bending it round the other side of the wall. That'd be a very talented player to do that, but Japarov is. Long wait before a kick is taken. Still we wait. It is Schatz's kick. And it's just wide of the uprights. I think Schwarzer probably had it covered.
Yeah, he and Lucas Neal just in tandem there. Lucas Neal dropping down onto the near post. Provide whatever cover he could there so that Schwarzer could watch the open goal, the open side of the goal. But another warning for Australia.
Cahill. Karpenko square. Haidarov has to be quick, and that's well stolen by Holman. Karpenko. Feels for offside for Australia, but Nothing doing. Wilkshire will sort it out. Maxim Shatsky scored nearly 100 goals for Dynamo Kiev. He was the replacement for Andrei Shevchenko, which tells you just how good he is. That's good combination play by Australia. Cure. Soccer is threatening again here. That's too many bodies around it. Perhaps he should have released it to Carney.
Well, that was well defended from Uzbekistan. They recovered nicely. They delayed Harry Kuehl perfectly. And they made Kuehl doubt what he was going to do with the ball and suffocated the space. And now Hasanov to show us what he's got down the left.
Looking for Japarov, but Miller Yedinak well positioned. Carney will thread it out for Mackay. Yedinak shows down the channel. Instead, they go centrally. Kuehl to hold it up. Good strength by Harry Kuehl. Cahill to Wilkshire. He's played that role well for Australia this tournament. Again, perhaps underlining his state of mind and the state of his body. This is actually not the first time these two nations have met in an Asian Championship semi-final. Last year they met on the same stage in the under-16s. And Uzbekistan won that contest by 2-1. But it is Australia who lead here, courtesy of Harry Kuehl. And this is Cahill. Kuehl just having to check the run. And he didn't check it quickly enough.
Yeah, and I thought probably the open ball out to Brett Holman was the one. Holman making enormous territory. You can see there on the wide shot, Kuehl's the choice, but Holman was the pass. He just completely blown Shakov Jurayev away, the left fullback.
Haidarov, that's an awful ball.
Yeah, probably not the man Uzbekistan won on the ball a lot in midfield. He provides a good fulcrum for the formation, but distribution isn't a strong point of his. Doesn't need to be necessarily when you've got Timur Kapadze moving out of midfield, Shervid Japarov moving in front of the defensive midfielders and linking up play. Kasanov and Shatskik as well.
Little nudge in the back from Lucas Neal. Well, look at the possession stats, Andy. Is that a true reflection of the game?
Yeah, I think they've been pretty dominant with the ball, Uzbekistan, and they've stretched Australia. The problem is keeping the back gate closed.
Holman again. Too slow.
Holman has been outstanding in that. His anticipation has been unseconded in this tournament. Australia can't capitalise. The highlights reel of Brett Holman in Asia Cup 2011, there'd be about a dozen of those steals.
Tends to nip it on the blind side as well, doesn't he? As Harry Kuehl has done there. Yedinak, now Holman. Now Akhmadov for Uzbekistan. Very talented player, Odil Akhmadov. There's lots of space here for Serdar Japarov, and he'll go for goal. It's comfortable for Schwarzer, but Australia can't afford to give him too much room, even from that sort of range.
Well, the danger was done before then, Simon. Australia, to maintain their lead, are going to have to maintain possession better than they're doing in the front third, the front half of the pitch. Too many easy turnovers, and Uzbekistan will build the pressure.
They've been pretty successful at doing that. They've scored at least 2 goals in every game this tournament. Although Holger Osik joked at the press conference that tonight was when that particular record came to a close. This is Japarov. Shmailov. Kapadze, directing the traffic up ahead. Homan nicking possession again, but this time illegally so.
Yeah,
I think this is probably fair enough.
Yeah, I thought the ref got that right.
Sasha Ognanovsky up against Ulugbek Bakayev. Be a good contest. Ismailov. Square for Akhmadov. Karpenko, he's given it away. Now Mackay on the charge for Australia. Threads it through, he's offside again, Harry Kuehl. But it's a clear tactic for Australia. First they pinch possession and then they break, and quickly, and that's tight.
They should have been onside, should have been play on. Probably, however, Matt Mackay should have removed all doubt and played the ball maybe two paces early. And another excellent piece of thievery from Matt Mackay. And then a crafty piece of attack.
Fascinating opening period of this second semi-final as Kuehl tries to get away from Akhmadov. Just leaned into his opponent, which has caused the referee to blow for the foul.
Yeah, again, fair enough. He left his running line to block the play of Akhmadov. Fair enough decision.
Kapadze finding Bakayev. Now Shatsky. Off, looking to go over the top, and Kasanov took it first time, and a foul by Wiltshire.
Well, it was a beautiful pass from Odil Akhmadov. I just don't think Australia can afford to allow him to bring the ball out from defence. He dropped that on a dime. It's a clear foul from that point on. Beautiful first touch from Yasur Kasanov as well. Nervous for Luke Wiltshire, already sitting on a yellow card. The referee showing understandable restraint, but the free kick nevertheless.
Maxim Shatskik to deliver this one. Will he go for goal or will he cross? He's driven it low and hard. Drops into the path of Kapadze. Wiltshire away for the throw-in. Shatskik. Haidarov letting it run. This is Akhmadov, who can hit them. Well, he scored from that sort of range against Qatar at this very stadium on the opening night of this tournament. Didn't quite catch that one as cleanly.
No, but the warning is clear. Uzbekistan players were asking for handball there. None could be coming. Handball has to be intentional. There's no way you could use Milojedinic of intent. Yeah. But it's Uzbekistan playing all the football. It's Australia trying to keep the field small and compact and looking to steal possession and launch a counter-attack, which in truth have looked pretty effective. But it's this part of the game where the Socceroos are struggling. The hold possession, build their own pressure. It's a super pass from Lucas Neal.
And this is Luke Wiltshire. Only Cahill in the box, and the angle was too tight for Wiltshire to get a clear enough look at a decent centre. Haidarov down the line for Kasanov. And Lucas Neal is another one who's had an excellent tournament here in Qatar. Across to sweep. Cahill, or rather Kuehl. This is Cahill. Now down the line from Wiltshire. Field trying to go around the outside.
He's a pleasure to watch, isn't he? Akhmadov. There's a lot of the Ned Zelich and Paul Okon in his effortless coverage of ground. Beautiful touch.
Playing in an unfamiliar role, of course, in the central defence. He is normally a central midfielder. Pushed into that position because of injuries, particularly to Yaroslav Krasilnitsky. There's the goal scorer for Australia after just 5 minutes. His 16th for his country. And how vital could it be? Well, the place in the final up for grabs here this evening. Cahill wants the corner, but won't get it.
But irrespective of whether the corner appeal came off for Australia or not, just much more relaxed moments for them. Keeping Uzbekistan turned and down in their own part of the field.
Kalpenko. Japarov. Being hustled by Carney. Draws the foul. The diminutive little midfielder who plays for FC Seoul in the K-League in South Korea.
For the time being, is he not on his way to a Lokomotiv Moscow? Big money move, as all are nowadays, into Russia.
Doesn't look too happy, no. Does he, Holger Osik?
Well, they've got one or two issues. There's no hiding the fact. They're making their task difficult because of their inability to get a decent share of possession.
Kalpenko, Haidarov, his passing range has really been off in these opening 30 minutes. Yedinak, more by luck than judgment, to the feet of Lucas Neal, who launches it long, looking for Cahill. And again, the flag is up.
Well, sooner or later, one of those offsides is going to fall for Australia. It's another very close one. Remember, in line is offside. And if there's any doubt, the assistant should be giving it the way of the attacking team. But Uzbekistan applying full field pressure. It's 30 minutes now and they've been working intently on keeping Australia pinned in. When Australia gets the ball, it's worked well for them. But more than a passing suspicion that Vadim Abramov has been spending time with our own Bernd Stanger in the hotel lobby.
That's well anticipated by David Carney. And away he comes. Rides the challenge. The goalkeeper's come out. David Carney! Oh, and he just got enough on it. Timur Juraev. Otherwise, Australia with two goals in front. Very clever play by the Australian fullback. And I just thought the goalkeeper there had got his angles wrong, but incorrect. He got it right. Just Shatsky. They've had a let off Uzbekistan. For all their nice and neat football, Andy, they've not really hurt Australia yet.
No, they haven't. Australia's been very compact. A couple of free kicks would have caused some nerves to fans of Australia. But it's that goal to Harry Kewell after 5 minutes which separates the teams. Could have been twice the advantage, but for that excellent work from Timur Juraev in Uzbekistan's goal. Held his nerve, held his feet. David Carney trying to surprise the goalkeeper. For that we can't criticise Australia's left fullback, but the goalkeeper was composed enough to deal with the issue. And a great chance for Australia. Continue to look dangerous. There is so much space in behind Uzbekistan's defence because they're pushing so high up the field. Oh, I suspect Vadim Abramov is not overly worried about the KLQ detente up front as far as speed's concerned. They think that they can turn and run down the Australian strikers, if indeed they do, breaks the line.
Harry Kuehl held up, but his determination has got him back into the contest. Uzbekistan trying to play their way out. It's coming unstuck for them on occasion. Unfortunately for Australia, Wiltshire was out of position when his pass was misplaced. And that's Kasanov. And Schwarzer plucks it out of the air with the greatest of ease.
Brilliant, brilliant from Mark Schwarzer. That's a nerve-calming take from Australia's number one. Instructive, this phase of play. We've seen it in previous games. Schwarzer takes a cross and goes for quick release. On this occasion with Matt McKay free, Schwarzer holds the ball and says, let's just steady it down.
McKay is pushed over, free kick. I can tell you that some of the Japanese players have just arrived at the stadium, eager to take a look at their final opponents, whether they be Uzbekistan or Australia. David Carney to deliver. Again, Ognjanovski and Neil have pushed forwards. Cahill leaps. It drops here for Ognjanovski, who scores! 2-0 Australia! Sasser Ognjanovski, what a year he's had! And that's the icing on the cake. Well, there may still be nearly an hour to play, but surely, Andy Harper, from this point, it is a long way back for Uzbekistan.
Well, I'm not going to get into that debate. What I am going to praise is the late career work of the Og Monster, Sasha Ognjanovski, on the building sites in Melbourne, hammering bits of wood together just 4 years ago. He's threatened to score goals this tournament, and finally he punches the net. He wasn't going to miss from there, not on your life. And Uzbekistan's crumple zone has been exposed.
Well, you called it, Andy. You said that the Uzbekistan defence had not been tested, as Holger Osa gives a rather muted response to that second goal. He knows there's still a long way to go. But they've been threadbare defensively, almost unrecognisable from the side that has performed so impressively at this tournament. Now, Australia have got a man down, Brett Holman. But Australia are continuing for the moment with Carl Valeri. And they'll get a corner, and now they can get some treatment too for their number 14.
Well, Australia will enjoy this two-goal lead more than many people could imagine. I think when in possession, Uzbekistan were in possession, Australia, as compact as they were finding the going tough. They couldn't put their foot on the ball. They couldn't secure possession. Their best route to attack was counter-attacks, and then they get a set piece, and they've just collapsed.
Could have been any one of three players there, Andy, to finish that off.
Well, indeed, but no one's going to deny Sasha Ognjanovski at this point in his career. Asian Player of the Year, captain Seong Nam to the Champions League of Asia, has made the latest of late starts to an international career, snubbed by former boss of the national team for his own reasons, given a chance by the new coach, and he's delivered big time. The trouble, should be said, he hasn't gone down for no reason. He's making his way very gingerly to the far touchline.
Brett Emerton and Robbie Cruz going through some limbering up exercises as Australia prepare to take this corner, which Uzbekistan have to defend a lot better than they did that free kick some moments ago. And Akhmadov does so. Not sure whether Brett Holman's going to be able to continue. That's a super tackle from Matt McKay. Pity about the cross.
Indeed, Luke Wilshere, one of the most consistent providers from the right-hand side. He got that wrong. Australia was amassed on the far. Kuehl, Cahill.
Brett Holman's going to give it a go. Wants to come back on. maybe try and run that injury off. Now, free kick has been given to Uzbekistan, and they want to get on with it. What? It's going to be a retake because they haven't retreated the 10 metres, Australia.
Well, and there's going to be a yellow card now for Cavalieri.
It was a soft award in the first place.
Cavalieri was in possession of the ball. I was getting ready to say that's a soft free. Has found an initial free kick and then taken umbrage at. Anyway, work to do for the green and gold defensively.
Japarov, low towards the near post. Shat's kick, goal kick.
He hasn't looked himself at all. Maxim Shat's kick in this tournament. That's got to be a goal kick, surely.
Well, he's awarded a corner, which is a complete mystery.
I don't know who's running the near touchline, but he hasn't been watching the same game as most of us for the last minute.
Japarov's corner. Miller Jedinak at full tilt. Mackay up towards Kuhl, who needs to hold the ball up and wait for support, which he gets now from Brett Holman. And again, super play by Harry Kuhl.
Super coverage from Odil Akhmedov as well. Brett Holman, pleasingly for Australia, is looking to have shaken that knock. Holger Osik, I can report, is at the edge of his technical area. A very quick chat with the near side assistant referee asking what on earth is going on. And now the fourth official's copying it from the German.
This is Juraev. There are two Juraevs on the park, incidentally, the goalkeeper and the number six, Sarkop Juraev. This is Kapadze. Haidarov looking for Viktor Karpenko. Too deep.
Cavalieri still asking the question of the referee. Better just to walk away and close his mouth. That decision has been made. This is Australia's second goal. It's just a wash with green and gold shirts. It's not strong enough defensively. You've got to have more about you in the semi-final of an Asian Cup than that. And they're here in good numbers, the Uzbek fans. They certainly outnumber Australia's contingent.
There's a few glum faces, though, in the Uzbekistan section at the moment, understandably so. They find a bit of room, Uzbekistan. Padze feeding Juraev. Hasanov. Bit short for Shatskik. Kapadze again. 5 minutes to go before the interval. Hasanov. Haidarov. Shatskik. Well, I've had plenty of this sort of possession, Andy, but haven't really been able to penetrate and get in behind the Australian backline.
No, they haven't. Their best outlet has been set pieces, but well, they've got good building blocks in attack because of their ability to keep possession. And the killer pass can come.
That's not a bad one from Kasanov.
The crossing's been poor. That's what's really let them down.
That's another example.
You know, it's still dangerous for Australia because in that front half of the pitch for Uzbekistan, their ability to keep the ball is going to force an opening at some point if they're patient enough. Australia's formation, you're right, Simon, hasn't really been tested. It's remained compact and coordinated.
Carney. Kuhl won't get to that. Haidarov sidesteps Holman. Juraev. Sometimes the transition is just a little too slow as well for Uzbekistan, allowing Australia to regroup. Karpenko. Smilov. Juraev. Just skim the top of David Carney's Barnett. Japarov. Uzbekistan need to get him much more involved in the game, in the areas of the park where he can be most dangerous. It's not a bad pass though. Haidarov, Hasanov, maybe chance for him to have a run at Luke Wiltshire. Opts for the cross instead, and it's another one that you can put in the disappointing box. Early release from Schwarzer, and it drops kindly for Cahill, and again there are big spaces in between the Uzbekistan lines. As you can see, two-thirds of the possession with the team in white, the White Wolves. But Australia, arguably, Andy, looking by far the more dangerous.
Well, there's no question, because they've got more space to play in. But what Uzbekistan are doing well is pressurising Australia in their own half of the field. What they're doing poorly is making sure the space over the top hasn't been picked up by a player providing cover and balance.
Karpenko. This time they go for the early cross. Schwarzer won't cut that one out, so they'll have a corner as back to step.
And they keep tapping away from free kicks and corners. They're going to believe that in the absence of a clear-cut chance, they'll be able to hurt Australia with a poor bounce of the ball, a deflected clearance or some such.
Now will be a good time to score for the White Wolves, just before half-time. Schwarzer clutches at the ball like you would a newborn baby. So it's Matt Mackay for Australia. Carney hangs a hopeful one up. That should be the goalkeeper's. And there's just going to be one additional minute at the end of the first half. I'm sure Holger Osik's half-time team talk will be a darn sight more comfortable than Vadim Abramov's.
There'll be a little bit of salt and pepper, though. We know Holger.
There always is with Holger.
He won't want people to relax on this lead, and he'll find something. He'll find a button to press somewhere.
Akhmedov. Kasanov. Japarov. Better by Uzbekistan. Now, Kasanov in a chance to cross the ball over. Karpenko! Well, he didn't quite catch it. I think it was on the half volley. And that's the final opportunity for Uzbekistan. And Australia are halfway to achieving their target of reaching the Asian Cup final. Goals from Ognjanovski after Harry Kuehler put them ahead after just 5 minutes, completing a very satisfactory first half for the Socceroos. At the interval in Doha, it's Uzbekistan 0, Australia 2. Well, Andy Harper, Holger Osik, despite what you mentioned there about the salt and pepper team talk, I'm sure inwardly he'll be absolutely thrilled with the scoreline.
There's no question about that, Simon. And generally, He will be very positive in his address. So let's not make any mistake here. It's been a very fruitful first half. But there's no question in my mind that he'll be finding one or two issues to pinpoint to keep his team on their toes, because they've got it all to lose from here. They've worked so hard over the last few days to freshen themselves up, lift the level again emotionally, and certainly patch themselves up physically. And they've got the break they needed. They're not having to chase the game now. That's the job of Uzbekistan, and Australia's experience particularly European experience and indeed World Cup experience now should really be serving them well.
Well, the scripts could not have been written any better for Australia. Just 5 minutes on the watch, and they've made a habit of pilfering possession on the right-hand side. Brett Holman has been instrumental in doing that, and he very nearly gave Australia the lead with just a couple of minutes on the watch. But the first goal was not too further down the line, Andy Harper.
No, well, the highlights will reveal that not only have Australia scored two goals, but they've had two other brilliant chances to make it even more, but for the work of Timor Gurayev. This is outstanding work from Matt McKay. The weight on that pass, once he'd done the turn and faced and carried the ball into the danger zone, then the weight of the pass to Harry Kuehl was beautiful. The finish, outstanding. Australia with a lead and a start to the football match that they can say barely have imagined possible. But this is it. Look at this from Matt McKay. Just to sense the onrush of the Uzbek defender and turn and carry the ball, and then the measure on the pass and the finish from Kuehl. And these two joined for the winner against Iraq, and they've joined for the first goal here in the semi-final. Brilliant stuff. The best part of Uzbekistan's play was around about this real estate. 10 to 15 yards outside of Australia's penalty area. They've strung together plenty of nice passes, but the shooting and crossing has really let them down. Australia, this will be the point Holger Osik makes if he's looking for one. Twofold. Keep the ball much better than we do when we get into the halfway zone. And secondly, we've got to restrict the crossing and shooting opportunities, because at some point, one of them's going to stick. With the second goal, completely forgettable from an Uzbek position. I mean, they got beaten physically in the air. And when the ball bounced, none of them were able to regain their feet. So firstly, they're beaten in the air with sheer power. Secondly, they haven't got the capacity to regain their feet once the aerial contest has been won. And then the Australians were queuing up. Look at them just collapse. And Ognjanovski, who had a bicycle kick cleared off the line in the quarterfinal by his own teammate, Petr Jelinek, there's no way he's going to miss from there.
Yep, the fairy tale continues for Sasha Ognjanovski. But it's been a bit of a nightmare, really, for Uzbekistan in this first half. As you say, Andy, plenty of possession. But Mark Schwarzer, who's equaling the Australian record for appearances today, has had a pretty easy night. So the half-time stats, Australia, despite the weight of possession being with the White Wolves, have managed five shots on target to Uzbekistan's three. They have picked up a couple of cheap yellow cards, though, Luke Wilkshire and Carl Valeri. They don't, of course, carry over until the final, so they're okay for the moment. But the important stats is the top line. Uzbekistan 0, Australia 2 at the interval, and the green and gold are on the brink, perhaps, of securing a place in the Asian Cup final for the very first time. 2-0 at the interval. Join us for the second half very shortly. Thank you. Well, Uzbekistan have scored two goals in every game of this tournament. They're going to have to do so again if they are to stay in this Asian Cup. Australia leading. Two goals to the good, courtesy of Harry Kuehl and Sasha Ognjenovski. And from their point of view, Andy Harper, I hate to invoke bad old memories, but back in 1997, Australia were leading Iran 2-0 and seemingly set for the World Cup finals. And a certain Khoda Dadazizi and a few others put them to the sword that day. And Azizi is here tonight.
Yeah, just sitting.
Couldn't be an omen, surely.
Well, he's just sitting to our right. So for the sake of Australia, let's hope not. Let's hope that nightmare remains where it belongs. But there's no doubt Australia are going to have to work very, very hard to keep on top of this game. There was a lot of football played by Uzbekistan, albeit without a lot of finishing touch or finishing threat, but it's still a good enough platform and they mustn't abandon it. What they've got to do is tighten up at the back. They've got to be stronger in of mind and body in defence, and they have to cover the space much better. It's all very well to pressurise Australia and try to force a turnover, which for part of the equation they've done well, but when Australia has looked to clear the ball down the field, there's so much space behind Uzbekistan's defence that the Australians have really helped themselves to. So the way back for Uzbekistan isn't that complicated. They just keep building on the foundations of possession that they've earned for themselves. They've got to make sure their shooting and crossing improves, most certainly, and they've got to be more vigilant in defence, but they're by no means out of this game.
But Australia, 45 minutes away from their first Asian Cup final and only the second major final in their history. No changes made by either coach at the interval, so it's as you were. Australia trying to launch the first attack of this second half, but Cahill has been penalised. He points to his chest and says, who, me? Yeah, it was you actually, Tim. You do wonder at times with Uzbekistan, Andy, whether it's a bit of a mental thing. We saw it in the World Cup qualifiers. There were, in that competition, rated as the dark horses of the final qualifying group, but flattered to deceive throughout, particularly against Australia. They seemed a little bit overawed.
Well, it's certainly going to become a huge psychological issue for them unless they can break the drought here.
This is Akhmadov trying to do just that. Japarov, now Karpenko. Valeri well positioned. Cannoned off the shins of Cahill, and there's a counter on here for Australia. Mackay's raking ball. Harry Kuehl's first touch a little heavy, and that allowed Haidarov to recover his ground and put it out to the corner.
Good coverage. Good coverage from Haidarov. Beautiful ball again, Matt Mackay. I mean, how good's he going at the moment? Harry Kuehl's touch on his less favoured right foot, I thought, was more than adequate, but it was excellent coverage from Haidarov. And to set up that attack, I thought it was a wonderful reflex touch from Tim Cahill. Didn't see a lot of accident about it. He knew the space on the left was open. His reflex directed the ball there, and Australia were away.
Wilkshire's corner, and Jedinak climbed highest, but couldn't direct it goalwards. Scored two goals at this tournament already, Miller Jedinak. That would have probably finished off the contest once and for all. And just on Matt Mackay, Andy, the old saying is that when you play with good players, you tend to improve your game. And boy, hasn't that been the case with Mackay? He's a good player in the A-League in Australia, but he's been sensational here.
Yeah, and I'm not surprised, Simon. Not surprised in the least. We saw Jason Kalina come back from his European career to play in the A-League, and a lot of discussion about whether that would hurt his World Cup chances and performance. Well, he was one of the best we had at the World Cup. This notion that playing domestically in Australia is overtly problematic is a nonsense. Matt Mackay is proving that, as Jason Kalina before him did.
And of course, Sasha Ognjenovski started off in the A-League, or at least played in the A-League. He played in the old NSL as well, of course. And he's on the score sheet tonight, along with Harry Kuehl, which have given Australia this comfortable lead. hesitate saying that. 2-0 has always been put forward as being a dangerous lead to hold. Harry Kuehl can't dig it out, and this is Odil Akhmadov. And Bakayev offside by about a metre.
Or was he? I don't know that they've got one offside right yet so far. The assistants, not even close. Quite sure how Lugbeck Bakayev could see, had his back to the line, but nevertheless he's right. Should have been play on. He, of course, is attacking the goal now, where he scored his two goals in 2 minutes after half-time in the quarter-final. That set them away. Jordan came back heroically to make it 2-1.
Late replacement for this tournament. There he is, Bakayev offside again. 32 years of age now, plays in Kazakhstan for FC Tobol.
Got that one right.
And Vadim Abramov was telling us at the hotel the other day that when he made the decision initially to leave Bakayev out, he was almost in tears, the striker. So when the injury occurred to Krushelnitsky, he had a rethink, but told Bakayev he would play no part until the knockout phase, which is interesting psychology.
Well, it worked big time. Two goals to win them the game.
This is Carney looking for Kale, who's so good at hanging in the air.
Confident Tim Kale is from that very improbable range and angle. He was still backing himself to score with the head.
Carney has gone down in a heap. Trailing leg of Bakayev doing the damage. Thankfully, he's okay. And Schwarzer goes long, and Kuehl anticipated that it might just break for him. Throw in Australia. Harry Kuehl playing that striking role as good as anyone I've seen in a green and gold jersey since Mark Viduka tonight. That's my big call for the evening.
He's been penalised here for illegal use of the body.
And Australia readying Robbie Cruz on the sideline. I wonder whether that injury sustained by Brett Holman in the first half is still causing problems, or whether it's another switch Holger Osik is considering. Kapadze finding Schatz kick.
Well, maybe it's Tim Kale himself, Simon, a huge injury cloud coming into the game.
Yep. Here is Holman. Doesn't look to have any problems with his movements. Kuehl, lovely first-time ball. Cahill looking for Jedinak. Now there's a bit of space for Servo Japarov to try and weave some of his magic. He tees it up for Kasanov. Maybe delayed too long. You haven't seen too many of those energetic runs, Andy, of Kasanov down the left-hand side.
No, it's been pretty sparing, but he does look dangerous. His crossing's left a bit to be desired, but in that front third out wide on the left, he's a very tidy customer.
Here's the change for Australia.
Harry Kuehl.
Well, I think you can say, as far as Harry Kuehl is concerned, Andy, job done. He's been terrific.
Yeah, he's contributed. I mean, what a launching pad for Australia. Saved the country's bacon in the quarterfinal against Iraq with that headed goal. And he set them away here after 5 minutes with that very trusty left foot. It's a great opportunity for Robbie Cruz. I'm going to say Harry Kuehl probably hasn't played as much football in such a proximity as he has the last few Asian Cup games. Barely any time to recover. But he's played his part, he's made his contribution, And Robbie Cruz adds another dimension speed-wise over the top. Here he goes.
Winning just his third cap, the Melbourne Victory striker. Said that when he was called up to this squad, he remembers as a child playing Tim Cahill on PlayStation. Now he's playing with him. Here goes Kasanov, but it's not a good delivery. Lucas Neal having to stretch to avoid the oncoming Bakayev. That'll be Schwartz's though. Again, they'll try and utilise Cruz, who combines with Mackay, the two A-League players. Cahill has arrived into the box. Here's Robbie Cruz. And Cahill waiting to snaffle the chance. Good introduction off the bench, though, for Cruz.
Indeed, a couple of good touches. More than worth the effort. He really glides, doesn't he, nicely, Robbie Cruz. And that was in the danger zone for Yureyev. Uzbekistan's goal there. Australians hovering for the crumbs. Kasanov makes way. It's a familiar substitution. At least one way. He can't play the 90 minutes, not in the eyes of Vadim Abramov.
And the new man is Manat Bikmaev, who plays in Russia for Alania Vladikavkaz. And he'll slot into Kasanov's role on the left-hand side of the midfield. Hopefully from Uzbekistan's point of view, he'll have a bit more impact. This is Japarov, out to Karpenko. Shatsky being forced back towards halfway by both Carney and Cruz. Jureyev. Sarkov Jureyev, that is. Now here's the new man, Bikmaev. Good positive start, and he goes for the return. He was headed off at the pass there by Luke Wiltshire. Referee saw no foul. Holman, good work to find Cahill. Needs help, gets it. Lovely turn and ball from Tim Cahill. They're working really well, Australia, in tight spaces here. Cruz holds it up, and now eventually it breaks down. But they were working ever so hard there. Jedinak, a bit clumsy.
I venture to suggest that was one of Australia's better passages of play. Now, Bakayev is getting a yellow card for his challenge on Tim Cahill. But the pressure from Uzbekistan towards that sideline, Australia played their way out, and it was looking very promising. Robbie Cruz just going for the narrower of the two passing options. Better serve to have opened the play to Matt Mackay. But Australia continues to make those passes stick, and they'll be very hard to head from here.
13 fouls Australia have committed. Two yellow cards, one for Uzbekistan. Akhmadov feeding it to Karpenko. That's a better delivery. Japarov climbs. Not really the man you want to be trying to win aerial duels. It's one of the shortest players on the pitch. Now, if Australia can thread it through here from Jedinak, Robbie Cruz is away, and he's not checked the run, he's offside. A super interplay between Cahill, whose earlier work was magnificent, and Miller Jedinak.
This angle isn't going to really tell us. It's close again.
Holger Osik is almost uncontrollable on the sideline. He is
enough.
Furious.
He's had enough. With this near-side referee, he's had enough. Assistant referee, he's been having a verbal stoush with him since that yellow card and free kick sequence against Carvalero. I think well refereed, nothing too dramatic required, just to exert the authority was all that was required from Ali Hamad Al-Badwawi.
Radio Vidmar acting as peacemaker. Good Asian experience on the Australian bench. Osik, of course, won the Champions League at club level with Urawa. Vidmar got Adelaide United to the final the year after.
Talked about.
Oh, that's a terrible mistake by the goalkeeper, and he's helped out by Ismailov. Goodness me. Temur Jureyev Well, he almost handed a place in the Asian Cup final to Australia. Gift wrap there. Robbie Cruz, so close.
Indeed. He's looking pretty sharp too. Those youthful legs of his.
Vic Mayev's cross, partly away by Neil. Uzbekistan posing a little bit more of a threat in the second half, but still Schwarzer not with too much to do. Maybe now, Akhmedov, Japarov. They can't find the angle to test the goalkeeper. Is that a foul on Cahill?
He's hoping so, but he's going to give it to the defender. Quite sure how. It's a situation of the referee not being overly happy with Tim's remonstrations prior to this.
There's that chance for Robbie Cruz. Well done, Azur Ismailov, the goalkeeper, just far too casual.
Well, Maxim Shatskik's disappointing Asian Cup has come, for the time being, to an end.
Sanjar Tursunov, who's been very impressive, certainly was against Jordan, will play on the right-hand side. Now Australia have snaffled possession again, and here they come on the counter through Robbie Cruz. Has he delayed too long? Feeds Yedinak. Now Wiltshire, Uzbekistan have regrouped. Holman gets a bit lucky. Carney. Exchanging passes with Valeri. Nobody too eager to offer support for Australia.
That's good work, Carl Valeri. That's better play, Australia. Robbie Cruz not confident that he could make the killer pass and decided not to put Australia into a disadvantage in transition. So it was good patience and Australia building from there as a result.
Mackay, this is good work. Valeri just loses out in the challenge. Look at the green and gold jerseys pouring back over their own halfway line. Determined not to give Uzbekistan one iota of room.
Well, the man on the ball is the danger man. He'll link with Server Japarov and Australia will be in trouble.
Bikmaev, Akhmedov. Bundled over by Yedinak.
He's a clever, clever player. Agile. Brett Emerton on now.
One Brett for another.
It's been another good performance from Brett Holman. And I think once Australia have done their defending, if they can hang on, Uzbekistan's defence is going to find Brett Emerton very difficult to contain. Half an hour to go, plus injury time and then extra time if required. Emerton will be fired up. Being left on the substitutes bench, it's a rare experience for him.
82nd cap for Brett Emerton, and his first job is to form part of this defensive wall. Substitutes Bikmaev lining it up, and Bikmaev fires wide, courtesy of a deflection corner.
Which Server Japarov looks to take, the skipper. Stung by Australia before, stung at club level, semi-final Asian Champions League by Adelaide. He'll have seen enough of Australian footballers for the time being. Work still to do.
Super play by Matt Mackay. Taking it away from Japarov. There's nobody above halfway bar Robbie Cruz for Australia. They don't need to chase the game, of course. There's confirmation of the scoreline with less than half an hour to go at the Khalifa Stadium in Doha. That's how close Australia are to a meeting with Japan in the Asian Cup final, which is back here on Saturday night, local time. Akhmedov spreads it out for Karpenko. Tursunov.
He's sharp, he's quick, he's dangerous. And he's off the bench and hungry and desperate to do something. David Carney just grabbing a handful of shirt. It's a good decision from the ref.
Here he comes again, Tursunov. Emerton back there to help. And look, everybody behind the ball for Australia. Japarov. Uzbekistan forced to make the play. Onside, Tursunov. Corner ball. Well, he's given a goal kick. And in fairness, I thought might have been offside first look. However, no, the replay suggests the linesman got it right.
Got 100% right. Nogninovsky sliding in, forcing the double rebound. Assistant referee on the far side, right on the job.
Well done, the officials.
He's become very good at blocking goal-bound efforts with his head. Jelinek, just unfortunate for Australia in the quarterfinal. It was one of his teammates' efforts.
Just gave him a centre parting there, didn't he? Are these the right tactics from Holger Osek with the game as it is ending?
Yeah, look, I think they've improved in the second half, as they needed to, in possession. The passes are sticking a lot better. Of course, that will become more of the case as hope continues to evaporate for Uzbekistan, who can't wait much longer before they give themselves an injection. The substitutes are looking lively. The danger men remain in that category. Man on the ball, Akhmadov, who just received it from the skipper. Japarov, they're the two most likely. A good speed on the wings now. And a very, very experienced goal poacher in Ulugbek Bakayev.
Japarov is robbed, though, by a sturdy challenge from Emerton. Now Robbie Cruz can set up the counter for Australia. They've got a man over here, Cahill. Just had to check to ensure that Mackay was onside. Carney arriving in support. Threaded through by Mackay and Carney! David Carney surely puts Australia into the Asian Cup final for the very first time. 3-0 at the Khalifa Stadium. The celebrations can start in earnest amongst the Australian fans. And Holger Osik's tactics have paid off. The Uzbekistan bench can't believe it. But with 25 minutes to go, surely that steep mountain has just become insurmountable for the side from Central Asia. Again, Mackay involved, and a very neat finish by David Carney.
Uzbekistan are understandably disconsolate. Matt Mackay with his second assist for the game. What a tournament he's having. And what a sweeping counter-attack, an overlap from David Carney, who tried the other route to goal first half, was beaten by the goalkeeper. Not second time coming for David Carney. Australia lethal on the counter.
Yeah, and they're looking for more. Cahill, but referee has rightly waved play on. They're looking for a fourth here. Brett Emerton's cross is not the best.
Well, play on was fair enough. Tim Cahill still hasn't got up. Let's see what the ref does from here. It's going to be a yellow card. Uzbekistan, understandably, fair enough. They're waving play on. I have no problem with this whatsoever. Tim Cahill's back to his feet now. He's not asking for sympathy.
Here's Akhmadov. They've got to score soon. Uzbekistan, here's Akhmadov! Oh, great save from Schwarzer. How many times have we seen that over the last few years, and indeed at this tournament?
Well, it's the afters that aren't pretty, but the entree was outstanding. I mean, he's a delight to watch. Look at the lateral movement, the agility through the hips. That's a naughty tackle as well from Bakayev. He's already on a yellow. He's going to get his second. It's all falling to pieces for Uzbekistan. And I can report quite confidently that Marat Bikmayev is very fortunate not to have seen a red card in that last exchange with Lucas Neal. It's another yellow now to Timur Kapadze. Goes from bad to worse from a coach who's won plenty of plaudits, rightly so. And his team is collapsing.
Well, they just lost their discipline, haven't they, Uzbekistan? And now, almost certainly, have lost the game as well. Here's a challenge. When you're on a yellow card,
naughty.
I mean, it's pointless.
Ridiculous.
It's on halfway as well.
Well, with his experience, too, I mean. Ridiculous.
Well, it's getting a bit ugly here at the Khalifa Stadium, and this scoreline could get ugly. Australia cruising towards the Asian Cup final.
Well, this is the performance Australia needed. Their finishing has been clinical. It's been poor till now. Credit to the players and the coach for fixing that. Uzbekistan's Achilles heel has been their defending. And there's been scant evidence of improvement on that front here tonight at the Khalifa Stadium.
They have been cut to ribbons. And credit to Holger Osik. He's got his tactics absolutely right. And it should be, a pretty comfortable last 20 minutes. Here's Cahill, pinching the ball again. Away he goes, past Ismailov, squares it up, Robbie Cruz could make it four here. Robbie Cruz, oh, good save by the goalkeeper. Still the danger not averted, Cahill. And now Uzbekistan will break. Well, Robbie Cruz will never have a better chance to score his first international goal and make it 4-0.
Now, hesitated badly, didn't he? The ball got stuck, and that would have been the end of the section. Even I would have put the cue in the rack at that point. But as it is, there's a faint glimmer of hope. Here's Robbie Cruz, offside. Can't understand why. That's the crucifix position. Ask the question.
Well, the boasts of Vadim Abramov are a shade over 20 minutes away from being firmly rammed back down his throat by the Australians. They've proved their fitness, they've proved their focus. Most importantly, ahead of a final meeting, you'd think, with Japan, they've proved their form. Unless there is a miraculous sort of a comeback from Uzbekistan, the 10 men of Uzbekistan. And here they go again. Two against one, and a goalkeeper forced to play auxiliary sweeper. And there's going to be a double change, one for each side here. Neil Kilkenny is coming on for Australia. Igor Ibrahimov will enter the fray for Uzbekistan.
Karpenko off. That's the one. Robbie Cruz should have made it four.
And Tim Cahill, probably understandably, is going to be replaced by Neil Kilkenny. He's been the victim, Andy, of quite a few crude challenges.
Time for a rest, you know. He's done his bit again. Australia need him in top form against Japan. Let's make no mistake, if they're to complete the job here, which is looking likely. And Neil Kilkenny's had a terrific tournament for the bits we've seen as well. And indeed, the practice game against UAE.
Cruz, this is Everton, could be four. And again, the goalkeeper's held him up. Credit to Temur Juraev. He's keeping the scoreline respectable at the moment.
Just. They're like a wet paper bag in defence. Uzbekistan.
They're a shadow of the team that has played so well at this tournament, Andy. Well, it's inexplicable.
It is, to an extent, Simon. When you look at who they beat to get here, Qatar game one were terrible. Qatar games two, three, and then quarter final were excellent, but not game one. Kuwait gave Uzbekistan the runaround, really, on the field, but weren't good enough to finish their chances. And they drew the final group game against China. They get to quarter-final here against Jordan, who offered enormous spirit, passion, fight, energy, great theatre. They were brilliant, Jordan, but they didn't offer as much football as Australia have offered today. And that was always, in my opinion, going to be the big question mark for Uzbekistan. How would they go under football pressure, not just physical pressure? How would they go under tactical pressure, not just emotion and guts? And they failed the test for the first 70 minutes at least.
Yep, the answer is not particularly well. Well, it's the Uzbek drums you can hear beating in the background, but there's been precious little rhythm about their team on the park. And for that, you must credit Australia. Kilkenny, good vision. Cruz with the attempted dummy, but well read on that occasion by Juraev. Now there's a chance for Tursunov. Back for the new man, Ibrahimov. Mackay, strong. I looked for Bikmaev at the near post, but the sheer presence of Ognjanovski was enough. Australia come away through Wiltshire. Well, look at this. If he's onside, Robbie Cruz is away. Will this be four? Robbie Cruz, he squared it up. Everton! Uzbekistan have been dismantled. 4-0.
Well, Robbie Cruz with the goal at his mercy. All he needed to do was beat the goalkeeper, Timur Jureyev, who has really stopped the hemorrhaging from being worse. But Australia's substitute, Melbourne Victory's star striker, has decided to play the ball to Brett Emerton. And I wonder if Brett Emerton ever figured in the Sony PlayStation Socceroos matches. But Uzbekistan have been summarily hung, drawn and quartered here at the Khalifa Stadium.
It is a wrap. And there could be more to come. We've still got 16, 17 minutes left for play. Smile on the face of Brett Emerton, who scores for the national team for the first time since November 2009. His 18th goal for his country. And here they come again. They're in the mood, Australia. Well, they struggle for goals in the early phase of this competition. That was the big question mark. They've all come in a rush tonight. Oh, slipped by Ognjanovski, could be in trouble. Recovers his ground. Vadim Abramov, and he was so confident this week, so confident.
But he wasn't the only one. There's plenty of the foreign press corps who didn't think Australia would figure in this tournament. But they've certainly thrown down the gauntlet now. Japan presents an altogether different challenge, we know that.
Here they come again, Matt McKay. They're queuing up here. Cruz, can he score this time? Oh, and again, he's denied by the goalkeeper. It will not go in for Robbie Cruz.
Well, just needed to lift this one. The workout at midfield, Matt McKay, a highlight all night. Against Iraq as well. Robbie Cruz just needed to lift that one. Went for the placement either side. I tell you what, Timur Jureyev is doing his best to fly the Uzbek flag.
Well, it's flying pretty limply at the moment. They have collapsed, Australia. Or Uzbekistan, I should say, in the face of the Australian onslaughts. Free header. Lucas Neal never scored for his nation. Looking to join in on the goal-scoring act. Well, do you think in his wildest dreams, Andy, Holger Osik would have thought this semi-final would have been so straightforward?
Well, straightforward is probably taking it too far, but very makeable semi-final. Iraq was always going to be difficult. Finishing top of the group was key. I mean, we just saw the first semi-final, Japan-South Korea. That was an unbelievable football game. Presents a completely different challenge for Australia. This was the makeable of the two semi-finals. I think we can be grateful that South Korea didn't put more goals on India. Remember, the group was decided on goal difference ultimately. So he wouldn't have believed maybe Uzbekistan to collapse as they have, but I'm sure Holger Osik, as the entire Aussie squad, confident that this was a makeable semi.
Mark Schwarzer still wants a clean sheet, of course. It's always the first priority for a goalkeeper. Emerton down the line, but Valeri turns in field. Just under a quarter of an hour to go. They're going to be long minutes for Uzbekistan. This is David Carney on the score sheet already. Good turn by Cruz. Getting good experience here, Robbie Cruz. He's got a bit of a knock too, Cruz. Wilkshire. Might just go on his own, Luke Wilkshire. Was he fouled?
Clearly.
Apparently not.
Well, Luke Wilkshire needs to make sure the red mist doesn't descend. He's hitting on a yellow.
You don't want to miss the Asian Cup final, that's for sure. Japarov. Not seen nearly enough of him from an Uzbekistan point of view. Sakob Juraev. Akhmadov. Just too easy for Ognjanovski. Emerton. Jedinak. Good first time ball looking for Valeri.
I can't think of many teams that maybe like Madov wouldn't look out of place in. He's a super player. Unfortunately, he's the only one of the White Wolves who's bared his fangs at all tonight. And if they had a psychological issue with playing against Australia because they hadn't beaten them till now, the manner of this defeat is going to make that a whole heap worse. Were it not for keeper Timur Juraev, it would have been a slaughterhouse by now.
Kilkenny. Neil. Carney. Just tried to do a bit too much. Official crowd attendance, by the way, just under 25,000. Too many Australians here, Andy. Do you think a few might make the flight for the final?
I'd like to think so. There have been a couple of messages from home of people who've said they'll be on the big bird if Australia can challenge for the trophy on the final day. We'll see if they're as good as their word.
Ten minutes to go at the Khalifa Stadium. Australia cantering into the final. Trip on Emerton. Kilkenny. Valeri to Wiltshire. Australia just happy to move the ball from side to side against the 10 men. Wait for the opening. Emerton. Ishmailov is back. He'll look straight to Matt Mackay. Cruz. Here's Mackay. Just wouldn't sit for him. Oh, no, he's bumped off the ball. He's not the biggest guy in the world, Matt Mackay. And I think he felt that. Here he is again, though, in behind. Squares it up, Valeri! Carl Valeri with his first international goal. And it is 5 for Australia.
Well, can Matt Mackay put on a goal? I'll tell a man he can. 3 assists in an Asian Cup semi-final to go along with the match-winning pass in the Asian Cup quarter-final. What a tournament for the skipper of Brisbane. And it's a fitting reward to score from Carl Valeri. Another lung-bursting performance from the Italian-based Aussie.
Again, not a bad backheel either, Andy, from Jedinak.
Indeed. Well,
but Cruz, that, sorry.
All the party tricks are coming out now. It's just been a phenomenal few games for Matt Mackay, who hasn't surprised anyone who's been watching him over the years. Carl Valeri, outstanding. And here we go again.
Well, the Uzbekistan side are ragged here. Cruz looking to get on the score sheets. Oh, he has! And finally, the goalkeeper's made a mistake. And Robbie Cruz does have his goal. And Australia are 6-0 in front. It's an embarrassment for Vadim Abramov and for Uzbekistan. They have been battered.
Well, Robbie Cruz's worst effort on goal is the only one that has brought any yield. And this is ridiculous from Uzbekistan.
Dear, oh dear.
That is terrible from Timur Juraev, who's been wonderful till then. I mean, you're wondering if he's had a personality bypass in the last 2 minutes.
They've thrown the towel in, Andy.
Well, that just collapsed.
I know they're down to 10 men. Never mind the White Wolves. They've raised the white flag of surrender, and those fans probably deserve a bit better. Six of the best administered by Australia.
Well, this is the heaviest defeat of any team in the tournament. As poor as Saudi Arabia were against Japan, they only got hit for five. The whipping boys of the competition, so-called India, people questioning whether they should have been here. Their heaviest concession was five against Bahrain. No one's been beaten by six goals. And believe it or not, we're in the semi-final stage of the competition.
It's not especially, Andy, a good look for the tournament, is it? To have a team being hammered by this margin in the last four.
Well, they've shown a soft centre. And then from this point on, World Cup qualifiers to come, of course, the draw for that later in the year. And anyone who plays Uzbekistan now will fancy their chances if they get to put pressure on certain parts of the structure. Their defending from the start of the match has been terrible. They haven't been tested all tournament. And the big test they've come up against, and they've wilted. Totally and utterly wilted. Apart from this bloke, whom I admire.
And who is surely destined to move to one of the bigger Western European leagues. There's already been interest in him. Here's Brett Emerton, who plays in one of those leagues for Blackburn Rovers in England. 5 minutes to go. It's hard not to feel a bit of pity for Vadim Abramov. Side has performed well at this tournament up until today.
Well, I feel more than that. He's an eminently decent bloke. We've enjoyed the exchanges with him at the hotel. He's urbane, witty, does things his own way. I don't think he pulled the right reins tonight, Simon. I mean, the scoreboard now has been an avalanche of goals, but when the game was in the balance, the key decisions, Karpenko and Shatskik, to me, didn't have the run in them. Defensively, they pushed too high up the field, which worked well to pressurise Australia, but they couldn't turn and chase and cover the space, and they were exposed ruthlessly. And like a deck of cards, they've just collapsed when under pressure. The second goal told everything. Challenging Ogdenovsky, three of them. None of them could beat Ogdenovsky in the air, fair enough, but none of them could hold their feet when they landed. And there was three or four Aussies there looking to help themselves to the second goal.
Well, it's going to be a different proposition in the final for Australia, that's for sure. Japan won't fold as Uzbekistan have done here. Can they perhaps win that final, Andy?
Australia, they won't start favourites. The recent record against Japan is good. Last World Cup campaign, a draw away in Yokohama, a win at the MCG, 2-1. Although this is a totally different Japan team from those qualifiers, one or two players. And they'll go in raging hot favourites. What a performance against South Korea in the other semi-final. And they've shown their mettle already, not just their quality. They've come back, overturned leads, they've had to play with 10 men.
Another defensive error by Uzbekistan. Australia hunting for more goals through David Carney here. Can he tee it up perhaps for Emerton? It'll drop out here for Kilkenny. No, it won't. Well, Uzbekistan are just begging for the referee to blow the final whistle. Now, just a point of interest, Tim Cahill has reappeared with some ice on his left knee to the subs bench. Maybe just bumps and bruises. Seems to have them all the time, Tim Cahill, but rarely prevents him from playing. I'm sure it'd have to be something very serious to keep him out of the final. Something perhaps to keep an eye on over the next couple of days. Now, Tursunov onside. Is there some consolation perhaps for Uzbekistan? Japarov. Here's a chance to Tursunov. And even now, Australia refuse to buckle.
Well, they want to keep this clean sheet intact, certainly Schwarzer. This is the heaviest defeat Australia have put on anyone since their move to Asia.
Yadanak won't mind conceding another. All smiles on the Australian bench. The party is set to start there. Tim Cale and Harry Kuehl headed clear. Almost underneath his own goalkeeper by Lucas Neal. And the long bomb is launched. Robbie Cruz has pace. And the goalkeeper takes charge. Perhaps a good job he did. Still they come, Australia. Last minute of normal time. Valeri. Kilkenny. Now Wiltshire. Square for Jedinak. Carney. And Australia just in total control, as they have been for quite a large swathe of this game. And they have done it in style. Now they quicken the pace. Cruz. Injury time, of which there will be 3 minutes. Japarov. Well, at least it's a shot on goal. If not on target. Full credit to Australia, though, despite the recriminations that will surely follow for Uzbekistan and for Vadim Abramov. Socceroos have done a thoroughly professional job. And there you go. Carl Valeri and Matt Mackay, the two willing workers in midfield. Clocked up nearly 12 kilometres again. They've covered virtually every blade of grass.
It's difficult to keep those numbers in context because of the collapse of Uzbekistan in the second half, but just getting on to Vadim Abramov's selections, I just didn't for the life of me see how Shatskik and Karpenko could keep up with Matt Mackay. He's put on 3 goals. Both of those two Uzbek players who I mentioned were substituted for the last of them, but the signs were there. For as much sympathy as we do have for the coach, I don't reckon he got that decision right.
Well, clearly, Alexander Geinrich, one of his key players, was not fit tonight because he's not appeared off the bench at any stage.
The problems weren't at that part of the field. I mean, he might have provided a little bit more of a cut and thrust in the first half when they had possession, but any time Australia had any go about them in the opponent's half, Uzbekistan were in all sorts of trouble. Let's not forget the number of saves the keeper has made, even in the first half. Brilliant save off Holman, good smother off Carney. As it was 2-0 by half-time. Second half has been embarrassing for Uzbekistan.
Cruz is quick, but he won't get to that. And we are into the final minute. All that remains is confirmation of Australia's place in the Asian Cup final for 2011. A few of the Japanese players watching on this second semi-final. Sure they'll have been taking a few notes. A touch off the head of Ognjanovski, and this may be the final play of the game. Indeed it is. It's Australia's day on Australia Day. The Socceroos through to their first Asian Cup final and only their second major final. Now can they finish the job off against Japan? The full-time scoreline, embarrassingly one-sided. Uzbekistan 0, Australia 6. Well, great scenes for Australia. They've earned this moment in the sun. Holger Osik, he's only been in the job a few months. But the players celebrate, the fans celebrate. All that is left for Uzbekistan is to commiserate. Not their night at all. The goalkeeper, Jiraev, prevented it perhaps from even being double figures. But credit to Australia, Andy Harper. They were too good, too strong, too clinical tonight.
To everything. A really, really good performance. Gives them a good platform for the final. They're going to have to go up a notch or two, there's no doubt, against Japan. But they had to deal with the team in front of them today. Favourites in many people's eyes, Uzbekistan, unbeaten in the tournament. Cruised through by comparison to semi-final stage, but they got found out big time here at the Khalifa Stadium.
Goals by Harry Kuehl, Sasha Ognjanovski, David Carney, Brett Emerton, Carl Valeri, and then latterly Robbie Cruz. Almost a cricket score for Australia. And even though a few in the crowd are wearing rugby and perhaps even cricket jersey, this team is the pride of the nation at this moment. They've only been in Asia for 5 years, but they're in an Asian Cup final for the very first time. A sterner test awaits against Japan. Perhaps a few tears amongst the Uzbekistan supporters. They had a good tournament up until today, but they were very much second best against a very classy Australian side. So can Lucas Neal become the first Australian captain to lift the medal?